Hello friends and welcome back. Now we will start solving some exercises on arrays. So if you have any doubts, don't worry. After we solve these exercises, you will feel comfortable working with arrays. In this video, we will solve our first exercise. So let's get started. The exercise is the following. I want you to write a program that fills an array with n integers entered by the user. I want you to suppose that the user can enter at least one number and at most 20 numbers. So you have to ask the user how many numbers he wants to enter. And this would be the integer n. And this integer must be between 1 and 20, okay? So you have to make sure that n is between 1 and 20. Now when you finish this exercise, I want you to resolve it with an array of points, not integers. So pause the video and try to do this. So how are we going to solve this exercise? First of all, we will ask the user how many integers he wants to enter. And I'm going to use a loop to make sure that this number is between 1 and 20. After that, I will create an array of integers of n elements. And finally, I'm going to iterate over the elements and fill them with values entered by the user using a scanner object. So let's go to IntelliJ. So first of all, I'm creating this scanner object to read input from the user. And after that, I'm asking the user how many elements he wants to enter, and I'm reading an integer from the user and storing it inside a variable n. So this variable will be the number of elements that the user wants to enter. After that, I'm using this loop over here to make sure that n is between 1 and 20. As you can see, the condition is n is greater than 20 or n is less than or equal to 0. So as long as n is not between 1 and 20, I will keep asking for another number from the user. So up until this point, there is nothing new. Now, after we get n from the user, I'm creating an integer array called numbers, and this array has n elements as you can see, alright? So the first thing we want to do is to fill this array with integers from the user. So we're going to create a method that takes this array as a parameter, and we will fill this array inside the method. As you can see, this is written in red because I didn't create this method yet. So to do that, put the cursor over here and press Alt and Enter. And have a look. We can create the method inside the class that is called main. So press on that and this will automatically create the method. But in this case, this method is private. At this point, we don't care if it is private or public. So you can change it to be public or keep it private, no problem. And it is a static method because we are using it inside the main method. And as you can see, it returns void. I will keep this void because this method will not return anything. I just want to fill the array inside this method. And this method is called fillArrayOfIntegers, and as you can see, it takes an array of integers. Perfect. So inside this method, we want to fill this array with values from the user. So first of all, we are going to use a scanner object. So let's create it. Scanner input is equal to a new scanner, and we will pass system.in, alright? After that, we want to iterate over all the elements of this array and assign them to be equal to a number from the user. So let's use a for loop. We will start from the first element, and we will move up until the last element. So I will be less than numbers.length. And each time increment I by 1. In the loop, we are going to access the element at index I and assign it to be equal to input.next integer. So we are reading an integer from the user and storing it inside the element at the index I. And this is our exercise. Now one more thing to do, I want to create a method and display the numbers for the user. So this method will take the array also. And let's press Alt and Enter and create it. It returns void and it takes an array of integers. Perfect. Inside the method, let's print something like this. The elements are, and let's use the print method. And after that, let's print the array using the arrays class. So I'm going to print arrays.toString and I will pass the numbers arrays like this. So we are filling our array and then we are printing the values to the user. So run the program and let's try it. So how many elements? Let's say I want 4 elements. Now let's enter 4 numbers. Let's say 5, 6, 3, and 7. As you can see, the elements are the following. Perfect. Now let's change this exercise to work with an array of points. So first of all this code over here will not change. But after we get n, we want to create an array of points. So let's change this over here to be a point, and also this over here should be a point. Now we have an array of points that have n elements. Now we want to fill this array with points and print it. So press on the name of this method and press Shift and F6. Now we can rename the method and this will automatically change all the occurrences that we use this name. Alright, so now I'm going to call this fill array of points. And as you can see, it is changing over here. Press enter and this is it. I will do the same over here, shift and F6. And let's change this to print array of points. Press enter and OK. Let's start with fill array of points. But just before that, let's rename this array using shift and F6 to be points. Alright, now over here, I want to change this parameter to be an array of points. So let's say point array and it is called points. And in this method, we want to iterate over all the points. So over here, change this points and we'll assign each element to be a new point. So let's say point sub I is equal to, and over here, we want to instantiate a new point. So let's create a new point and this point takes an X and a Y. So let's take X and Y from the user. Let's say input.nextInt and also input.nextInt. Now to make this more clear, I'm going to print enter X and Y, all right? And I'm going to add some braces for the for loop and I will bring this print method inside the for loop and let's put this over here. Now let's modify this to be something like this. Enter X and Y for point and after that, I'm going to print an integer which is I plus 1 and let's concatenate. So now we will say enter X and Y for point 1, then X and Y for point 2 and so on. And in this case, I want to use the print method. And this is it. Now let's change the print array of points. Let me copy this parameter and I will put it over here. And now I'm going to print the points using a for loop. I don't want to use arrays.toString. So let's iterate over the points. We will start with the first element up until the last element and each time increment I. In here, I'm going to print using the println method a string that starts with a parenthesis. And after that, I will concatenate points sub I dot x. So I'm getting the element at index I, which is a point, and I'm printing the abscessa. After that, I will concatenate a comma and a space. And followed by that, I will concatenate the ordinate. So points sub I dot y. And finally, we will close the parentheses. So we will display all the points in this format. Now let's try the program. Let's say we want 3 points. Press enter. And as you can see, enter x and y for point 1. Let's say 1 and 3. And now we are entering the second point. Let's say 8 and 4. And finally, 0, 1. Press enter. And as you can see, these are the points. And to make this over here go to the next line, I'm going to use the println method over here. Alright, and let's remove this space. It will not make a difference, but this is cleaner. So this is it. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.